All right, night one.
Oh. Hey, buddy. It's Jake here in level two.
Hi there.
It's great to see you've woken up from your coma.
Yep.
I was starting to get a little worried there. Yeah. You're now a patient in the old hospital on the top floor of the asylum. You're the first patient we've had up there in years. And you'd better make yourself comfortable because the doctors want to keep you in for a few days yet. Fortunately, there's no asylum inmates to trouble you up in the old hospital. But the hospital is haunted. Anyway, you have nothing to fear because we've set up a security system for you.
With me,
so you can use your map console to open and close the doors around the hospital.
Yep.
If any spooks do show up, you can use the doors to keep them away from your room. Just remember, though, you won't be able to trap a ghost in one room for the entire night. After a while, they'll realize they can just pass straight through the closed doors. So expect them to keep you on your toes. Oh, there's also the old technical issue, which means you can only close three doors at any one time. But I'm sure that'll be plenty. We've also set up electromagnetic sensors around the hospital, which will pick up any ghostly activity. Use the map console to turn the sensors on. But remember to turn them off when you're not using them, because they drain the power real fast. Your room has also been fitted with an alarm, which is triggered by sudden changes in temperature. If a ghost is nearby, the temperature will drop and the alarm will sound. Fortunately, there's no door to your room, but we've set up a high-powered flashbulb for you to use. The sudden flash of bright light should scare away any ghosts. Yep. Okay, that just about covers it. Just remember to take it easy and get plenty of rest tonight. We don't want you slipping back into a coma. And don't let your heart rate get too high.
I won't.
There's plenty of morphine available if you need it. Okay, buddy. Have a restful night.
All right. Have a good day. Alright, this is the wonderful hospital, so he said don't make the heart rate get too high. Maybe I could use this to scare away any ghosts. Yep, I can find something that can to scare away any ghosts. Get out of here. What now? What? Dead? Yep. Game over. Let's try it again. I'm not supposed to do something when I check the cameras multiple times. Skip this. Yeah, skip this. Hello again.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah,
it's Jake
again.
Here in level two. It's great to see you've woken up from your coma. I was starting to get a little worried there. You're now a patient in the old hospital on the top floor of the asylum. You're the first patient we've had up there in years. And you'd better make yourself comfortable because the doctors want to keep you in for a few days yet. Fortunately, there's no asylum inmates to trouble you up in the old hospital. But the hospital is haunted. Anyway, you have nothing to fear because we've set up a security system for you. You can use your map console to open and close the doors around the hospital. If any spooks do show up, you can use the doors to keep them away from your room. Just remember, though, you won't be able to trap a ghost in one room for the entire night. After a while, they'll realize they can just pass straight through the closed doors. So expect them to keep you on your toes. Oh. There's also the old technical issue, which means you can only close three doors at any one time. But I'm sure that'll be plenty. We've also set up electromagnetic sensors around the hospital, which will pick up any ghostly activity. Use the map console to turn the sensors on. But remember to turn them off when you're not using them, because they drain the power real fast. Your room has also been fitted with an alarm, which is triggered by sudden changes in temperature. If a ghost coast is nearby, the temperature will drop and the alarm will sound. Fortunately, there's no door to your room, but we've set up a high-powered flashbulb for you to use. The sudden flash of bright light should scare away any ghosts. Okay, that just about covers it. Just remember to take it easy and get plenty of rest tonight. We don't want you slipping back into a coma. And don't let your heart rate get too high.
I won't.
There's plenty of morphine available if you need it.
Okay.
Okay, buddy. Have a restful night.
Alright, have a good day. Alright. Alright, because I got jump scared at the end. Come on. Oh god, that's loud. Oh, hello? Get out of here! Oh god, oh god. No. Oh god, what? Please, almost 6 a.m. Come on, almost 6 a.m. Oh, thank you. Right. Yeah, I have a one.